Hello everyone, welcome to Stack Developers channel. And in this video I'm going to bring Laravel 8 new features and changes. Okay, so from last 2 days I am exploring Laravel 8 new features and what Laravel 8 brings to us. Okay, so there are few changes Laravel 8 brings, and I want to practically show you that what changes Laravel 8 brings to you. Okay, so first of all I will install Laravel 8 once again. See, in last video we were able to install Laravel 8 both in Windows and Mac. Okay, so I am going to do this one once again because then I will show you practically that what changes Laravel 8 brings to us. Okay, so I can simply run this command. Okay, you can go in laravel.com website, installation of 8 version, select version 8. Okay, and go there and you can run this command. I am going to run this command in my Mac. Okay, if you are in Windows, you know that how to run your command in Windows, git bash here or something. Okay, so here I am going to do new terminal at folder, right click, paste, and I am going to make it like Laravel 8. Okay, so the new Laravel 8 version will get installed. It will only take few minutes, so don't worry, it will only take few minutes in Mac. Okay, but in Windows it takes a bit more time, but in Mac it will install quickly. Okay, so I have already made some notes, and don't worry, these notes are also in video description. You can see these notes are there. So there are three most important features we can say that are in Laravel 8, and one is the separate models folder. Okay, so models folder is separate, that never happened earlier. It's now like controller is having separate folder, middleware is having separate folder, now model is also having separate folder. Okay, earlier on all models are scattered everywhere. Okay, we know that it's under app folder, but now it's under models folder in Laravel 8. Okay, so other things are PHP addition, serve enhancements, so this one also I will tell you, and routing namespace change, this one also I will practically show you that what changes Laravel 8 introduce. Okay, so first let me install Laravel 8, then we will see that practically going to check. You can see our Laravel 8 is installing, so it will take few minutes. We need to wait for few minutes, then we will start working on the changes of Laravel 8. Okay, so let us install first Laravel 8. Okay, you can see our Laravel 8 has been installed. Okay, so now we will check the version also. So I will close this one and we'll check in my acidocs folder that Laravel 8 has been installed. Here it is, Laravel 8. Okay, so all the files are here, and I am going to check its version also once again. Services, new terminal at folder, PHP artisan version. Okay, so let me check the version also. Version is 8.1.0. okay, so it's Laravel version 8.1. okay, so our Laravel 8 has been successfully installed, and now I'm going to run also, and we'll check here PHP artisan serve. So let me see, okay, so this is the new screen of Laravel 8. We already know in last video that Laravel 8 new screen look like this. Okay, it is different from the earlier versions of the Laravel. Okay, so one change is this one, that we have got the new screen, but I am not talking about this one, I am talking about the major changes. Okay, so those are the major changes that I am showing you. So first change is separate model folder. Okay, now I will take you to Laravel 8 folder. Here app, HTTP, here you can see like controllers, middleware, and the same way we have the models folder. See here, it's user model that comes by default with Laravel 8, comes inside that models folder. Otherwise this file is outside of this, this file is located somewhere here. Okay, and there is no models folder. If you will check the earlier versions of Laravel, you will check in Laravel 7 or Laravel 6. Here you can go and you can check the earlier versions of Laravel. Okay, here this is the earlier version of Laravel. Here you can see app, there is no more model folder, and see the user model is outside, it's straight away inside the app folder. Okay, so this is the first change, that in Laravel 8 you will get the separate models folder. Now there will be no confusion. If you want to update any of the model, just you need to go inside the models folder, and here you can update your models. Okay, so I am going to practically create model, and model will get created inside this models folder. And good thing about this is, like, if you don't want this approach, okay, then you can simply delete the models folder, and you can copy this, you can move this file outside of the models folder, means here only, then it will again work. Just you need to update that namespace. I will show you how. Okay, so now let me do one thing. Now we are going to practically experience all these kind of things. So I will pick this project here in my Sublime, Laravel 8 Sublime. So first change I am going to do, and I am going to update .env file. I will make one db for Laravel 8, and here I will make one db. So I will quickly make one db like Laravel 8 like this. Okay, so here I will use this one here, Laravel 8, and one command I'm going to run here, right click php artisan migrate to get all default tables, php artisan migrate, so that all default tables will get created, user table, password created. Okay, so see now, fine. So now what I will do, I will open its route web.php, and okay, so now I'm going to create one new model, and I want to create one table also. So I will create the table here, like products table. I'm going to create, not with migration, but like this one. Here I will quickly take it, like ID name created at and updated at. Okay, so here auto increment go where care 255 and date time timestamp. Where is the timestamp? Okay, so this one, save. Okay, created. Now see what I'm going to do. I am going to create one route for this one. Okay, for showing all the products, our all points will get covered with this one. Okay, all changes we will experience in this Laravel 8. So I am going to create one route, simple route. Like we used to do, I will make one press controller, and I will make one function like this one, products. Okay, and I will create one model also, product model. I'm going to create click php artisan make model product. So here I'm going to show you that app models, see, product model automatically created in the models folder. Okay, so in Laravel 8 we get separate models folder, and in that models folder our all models by default get created. Okay, and if you don't want it, you can just bring this outside after deleting models folder as well. If you but I will, if I will do new project in Laravel 8, then I will continue with this one, okay, because we want to use the new features of Laravel. And see, last time we have also upgraded our project to Laravel 8, but in that such changes will not happen. Like we upgraded our Laravel advanced Laravel e-commerce series in Laravel 8, and now this one is in Laravel 8, but it's still you can see models are still outside. There is no separate folder for model. Even this project is in Laravel 8. I will show you that this project is in Laravel 8, this test 6, and this one ecom project we are doing advanced ecom series in Laravel 8. This project is in Laravel 8, and here you can see all the models are outside. Here you can see all the models are outside. There is no change has come. Even we have upgraded the project to Laravel 8. Okay, you can right click, go, and you can test here PHP artisan version. This is the Laravel 8. Even then, see 8.0.4. Even then, there is no change as far as the model are concerned. Okay, this point I have also shown you here. Now, if you will study that, you will clearly notice that. See, first point is separate models folder. We get the separate model folder. Earlier, we are making the models inside app folder. Now we are making the models folder is inside app folder, and inside models folder we are going to create all the models in the new version of Laravel 8. Okay, but see here, if you upgrade from Laravel 7 to Laravel 8, nothing such thing will happen. Okay, otherwise we need to work too much. Otherwise developer will have really tough ask. Developer need to we need to move all the model to the models folder, and we need to include its path also. Path will also change. Okay, so here you can see I'm going to do this one, but before that, one issue will come up. That issue I will also tell you that what issue, and that is the different thing that we are going to work on. Okay, so here I'm going to product controller we have created. I think we have not created. I'm going to create the product controller as well. Okay, so now we have created the product controller as well. I'm going to show you. Here I will create public function products. Here I am going to get all products like we used to get every time from the product model. I'll use get, then I will use to array to show in array, and I will use dd to show all products. Simple enough. Okay, nothing much. This is the simple task. And here, see, now this will not work. Now it is not possible to do like this. Use app, this one we used to do like this, but now our product model is inside the models folder, so we need to add here models. Okay, so this one is the change. It's not inside the app, it's inside, not inside the app, it's inside the models. Okay, so here you can see app then models. Okay, so we will add here models like this. Okay, so that's why I am practically showing you everything, because otherwise it is really tough to theoretically explain you. I am practically explain you, because you can, if you will start your Laravel 8 project, then you must know these kind of things as well. Okay, so this is the first chain and second chain. See, now one error will come, and that error is something like target class does not exist. Here I will show you that if you will run products that we have made the route for this one, sorry, everything and we'll run again. I'm going to run again Laravel 8. So see Newton Red folder PHP artisan sir. Okay, so I will refresh here. See, the issue is target class does not exist. Okay, so what's the issue? See, we have done everything. You have seen that simple steps, products, this route we have created, product controller at the rate of products, and then here. So the issue is of the namespace. There is some namespace change in Laravel 8. Okay, so we need to do one thing to resolve this issue. We need to directly call the products controller, means we need to give the full path of products controller where products controller is stored. Okay, so we can resolve this one. Like I have also shown you here. See, routing namespace change. Now we need to give the full path like app HTTP controllers. Okay, this one I will add in front of like this controllers, like this. Now it will work fine. Okay, so now it is working fine. We have not inserted any data. So insert data like any data, t-shirt. Okay, so now it is coming, data is coming, because we have directly given complete path. So in Laravel 8 we need to give the complete path, but rather giving it for every route, we will add in group. Okay, like we used to do in our project, also in our advanced ecom series also. Don't need to worry about this thing. Very simple task we will do, like here. See, nothing to worry about our earlier products. Even we have upgraded it to Laravel 8, there is no change. We need to do like this, but for the new products we just need to do like this. See, just we will add this one. I will show you. We will add here prefixes not required here, only namespace is required. In namespace I will add this one, cut from here, and we'll add it here. Okay, so this is the simple thing I am going to do. Now I can even write here 50-60 routes, 100 routes I can even, and no need to write it again and again. Okay, so just write it one time here in group itself. And I have also mentioned this one here, that you no need to, you just give it in group, and then everything will remain same. Okay, so I will now try once again and it will work fine. See, it is still working. Okay, so give it like this and then there will be no trouble. Okay, so two things we have studied so far. One is the namespace. You need to give the complete namespace. Now wherever this products controller is present, we need to give that complete path. Now, not like earlier where it automatically picks. In Laravel 7 and earlier version it automatically picks, but now you need to give the complete path. Okay, and the second change is our model is now located inside the app models. Models is the separate folder for all the models. Now even if you have the another world, like if you want to add the user model as well, include the user model, then you need to do here like this, user edit user model. Okay, so these things you can do. User model, see, every model, all model will be located inside the models folder. Okay, so like this. So now the third change. Now there is one more change. Suppose it happens many times that you want to update .env file and you want to add something in your env file, or you want to simply change the database name. Like if I created the new database for our project and I want to use that database, like I want to use the database like our database ecom6. Okay, So this database I want to use, then we need to restart Laravel. We need to close this one and we need to start again PHP artisan serve command, we need to do again. So but here in Laravel 8 there is no such requirement. You can make the changes in your .env file and no restart is required, no Laravel restart is required. You can simply make the change in your .env file and the changes are reflected instantly without any restart is required. See, I have made the change here, save and refresh. Okay, so all the new data has come up. See, the data here is now coming from the another database. We have just added the two entries there in our Laravel 8 database, but now this is the another database. This is the ecom6 database and the result you can see the change has come instantly. Okay, only this is possible in Laravel 8. This is the third change Laravel 8 brings. And here this one also I have mentioned here, PHP artisan serve enhancements. Okay, so no need to restart Laravel even if you make any change in .env file. Okay, so these three are the most important changes, most important features of Laravel 8 that you must know before start the project in Laravel 8. Okay, so I hope that everything is clear. If you have any confusion, you can surely contact me. That's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.